life, oh God. Yes. We thank you, oh God, that we're not lying in a hospital bed on a respirator this morning, oh God, with everything that's going on in this land right now, oh God. Oh, we bow down to you right now, God, and we say thank you, Lord. We say thank you, Lord. We say thank you.
Welcome to All Power Ministries, where God is empowering His people to be more than conquerors and overcomers.
One of our own, Pastor Emmanuel, amen, who is a native of Africa. He's going to be bringing the word this Wednesday, amen. And so I just, you know, he brought a word about a couple months ago, and it was a powerful word, amen, amen. Many of you really enjoy that word. And so I'm quite sure he's got something from the Lord again, amen. And so just be prepared to take off, amen, amen, and run with him, amen. At this time, we're going to bring him up, amen. At this time, come on up, Pastor. Amen. God bless.
Hallelujah. We are praising the name of the living God tonight. Because God is wonderful. God is marvelous. And God is good for our life. One thing that I know that everything will pass. But the word of God will stand forever. The good houses will pass. The beautiful road, the beautiful places will pass. But the word of God will stand forever. Amen. We know that we are here for a temporary time. Because we are the visitors in the earth. At the end of the time, we're going to leave the earth and go back to our Lord Jesus Christ. But I'm here this evening to strengthen you that do not be afraid because the Lord is with you. Amen. Amen. This evening, we are going to teach. I prepare a really very long teaching, and I know that by the grace of God we are going to have time, because I will not end up this teaching tonight, but I know that as long as the days continue, I can find favor on the side of the pastor so that he can give me the time again to continue this teaching. Amen. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I give you praise, O Lord. I give you honor. I give you glory. You are God, O Lord, and nobody is like you. You are God, O Lord, and nobody can be compared to you. You are God, O Lord, and nobody can be qualified to Father. You are the Father of the fatherless. You are the stone of corner. You are the rock of ages. Father, I say thank you for tonight. Use me, O Lord. May I disappear and you to appear. I want me to close my mouth and you to speak through me. Father, thank you for your presence. In the name of Jesus Christ, Father, I pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Tell to your neighbor, you're going to receive something tonight. Tell your neighbor, tonight is your night. Be prepared for the word of God. So we are going to teach tonight about the knowledge of the last days. The knowledge of the last days. Hallelujah. We are going to break 7 points about the knowledge of the last days. First of all, and the first point, we are going to see the sign of the last days. What is the sign of the last days? How are you going to discover that we are in the last days? What is the element that you're going to see that's going to pop up? And you're going to figure out that this belongs in the sign of the last days. We are going to see in the Bible. In the sign of the last days, we are going to see Matthew 24, 4 up to 14. 2 Timothy 3, 1 up to 5. The sign of the last days. Matthew 24, it says about when Jesus Christ was trying to explain about how we're going to see the world, how the hunger, how we're going to see the people raised against other people, the kingdom against other kingdom. We're going to open all those verses and explain more about it. Matthew, 2 Timothy, 2 Timothy 3, 1 to 5. We are going to see how in the last days, the people will be selfishness. In the last days, the people will be lover of money more than God. We are going to see in the last days how the children will rebel against their parents. We are going to see in the last days how people will not have the love of the work of God. This is in 2 Timothy 3, 1 to 5. And you are going to figure out in an easy way that we are living in the last days. Every point you're going to see how people love freedom more than listening to their parents. You are going to see how people love money more than everything. It is in the Bible. The people will be lover of money. We are going to see how people are going to start to love themselves more than to love others. We are going to see how people the children will rebel against their parents. Never listen to their parents. It is in the sign of the last days. Amen. Eh? The second point, we are going to see the cut short of days and the rapture of the church. The cut short of days and the rapture of the church. When I'm saying about the cut short of days, the Bible says if those days could not be cut off, no one could escape. Yep. It came in the mind of the Lord to cut off those days because he looked on earth and discovered that if I keep going on, nobody could escape. The devil is working in a hard way. I have to cut off those days so that at least I can have some people who are going to celebrate the marriage of the bride. The cut short of those days and the rapture of the church. We're going to see how the rapture of the church is going to take place. We're going to see the element, the sign, the consequences that's going to pop up after the rapture of the church. It will be horrible. Horrible. We are going to read Matthew 24, 22. Matthew chapter 24, verse 22. We are going to read 1 Thessalonians 4:16 up to 17. 1 Thessalonians 4:16 up to 17. The rapture of the church. In the second point here, we are going to break down this second point, the cut short of days in the rapture of the church. We are going to break it down in 3 points. 2, 1, the trumpet. 1 Thessalonians 4:16, how the Bible says that the archangel, the big angel of the Lord will blow up the trumpet and the holy will raise up. We are going to see how this is going to happen. The second point, we are going to see the secret of resurrection. The secret of resurrection. We are going to see it in 1 Corinthians 15:52 up to 54. The secret of resurrection. 2, 3, we are going to see the goal of the rapture of the church. I'm telling you guys, we're going to spend more time here. The goal of the rapture of the church. Here we are going to see how the church, the reason why Jesus Christ take care of the church on earth quickly. We are going to see why Jesus Christ choose good to do it in secret. Because the church is the bride of Jesus Christ. And this is the time that Jesus Christ wants to judge the church according to the work of everybody. And a man can never shout to his wife publicly. A man can never advise or speak the weakness of his wife in public. No. A man, if you want to speak the weakness or to correct his wife, bring her in the bedroom, in the secret place. So here we are going to speak between me and you. This is the reason why make Jesus Christ take care of the church in a secret to go to correct the church. I am your husband. You are my wife. Okay, let me show you what you did now. He could not do it on earth, the place where the pagans gonna start to look at you and say, okay, you was preaching Jesus Christ. So your Jesus that you was preaching, he ashamed you on my presence. No, Jesus Christ didn't choose to do that. He took out the church to go to correct his bride in secret. This is what we're going to see. The secret resurrection. How the church gonna go and be in heaven, in air. The Bible don't say in heaven, in air. So they are gonna correct you. So, okay, you was an usher in the church. You was an apostle in the church. You was a pastor in the church. You was a prophet in the church. You were a bishop in the church. Okay. I give you the mission. How did you lead my sheep? Okay. You was an evangelist in the church. Okay. How did you do the work? If you were coming in the church to look how people dress up, that day, it's going to show up. If you are coming in the church only to waste your time, that day, he's going to tell you. If you are coming in the church only because you don't have nothing to do home, that day, they're going to tell you. If you don't preach Jesus Christ, you preach what you know, that day, he's going to tell you. To correct the church in secret. In this goal of the rapture of the church, we are going to see the 7 years that the church going to spend in here. In the 7 years, going to break down 3.5 years. The first one, the second, 3.5 years. The first 3.5 years, what will happen? We are going to break it down. Let me say something about it. The first 3.5 years, Jesus Christ will test the work and give you crowns. They will test the work of everybody and give crown. Let me break down this quickly. In this goal of the rapture of the church, we are going to see, first of all, Jesus Christ, he wants to bring us to be with him where he is when the rapture of the church gonna take place. John 14:3. The Bible says, where I will go, you will go too. He wants our body to be changed in the goal of the rapture of the church. Because this body will change to the glorious body. we are going to undress this body, and we are going to dress up a glorious body. This is among the goal of the rapture of the church. Another point, he went to do the wedding of the bride. The wedding of the bride. Revelation 19, 7 up to 9. The goal of the rapture of the church. The wedding of the bride. He went to test the work that we was doing on earth. We are going to see 1 Corinthians 3, 13. To test the work of everybody. What he was doing on earth. You are calling Christian. You are going to church. That's right. It's good. So that day, you are going to test what he was doing. He wants those who are qualified to receive crown according to their works. Because here we are going to see five types of crowns. And those five types of crown, I'm going to break every crown down. But we're going to see who will receive this kind of crown, who will receive this kind of crown, who will receive this kind of crown. Because as there is five types of crown, is according to five ministries. Everybody receives his own crown. And the last point, he wants to rule and to reign with the bride in the millennium. Revelation 20, 1 up to 3. This is in the goal of the rapture of the church. I'm telling you guys, this is very serious. And when I received the revelation of this, because the revelation that I received, the Lord directed me to some place where I was being taught more and more. Because I was to the Bible studies for 3 years, and we saw a lot of things about this. The second point that we saw here was the cut short of days and the rapture of the church. The third point that we're going to see is the judgment seat of Christ. The judgment seat of Christ. In the judgment seat of Christ, we're going to see 2 Corinthians 5:10. The judgment seat of Christ. In the judgment seat of Christ, it's the time that Jesus Christ will keep continue to judge the church, to speak about the weakness of everybody, to speak about how you was leading the church, how you was become, how you was reacting in the church. Here, we are going to see how people gonna react at that time. We are going to break down this point. 3:1. The test of our works. We're going to continue this part. That's going to take 3 years and a half. And the second one will be the gift of the clean garment and the wedding of the bride. Because on this time, that they are going to test the work of everybody. After testing the work of everybody, they are going to distribute crown for everybody. So those their works will stand, because the things that Jesus Christ is going to use to test the work of people will be fire. He will use fire to test our works. The Bible says in the book of Corinthians, the works of some people will be like leaves. The works of other people will be like wood. The works of other people will be like gold. That's what the Bible says. Because if you take gold, you throw it in the fire, it will get out shining. But if you take wood, you put in the fire, it's going to be consumed. If you take leaves, you put it in the fire, it will be consumed quickly more than wood. So that is the work of everybody going to look like. If you was coming in the church for joking, your work will be like leaves. If you was coming in church for appointment, you are coming for appointment to see somebody, or you are coming to waste your time, your work will be like wood. But if you are coming to church to preach the gospel, to pray God so that the work of God can go forward, oh, hallelujah, your work will be like gold's. That day, some people are going to cry. Other people are going to celebrate. Taste our works. I'm telling you guys, this is so powerful. And people don't realize this because other people, they don't understand what is the difference between going to church, what is the difference between stay home. They can come to church because sometimes they don't have something to do. But understand that be a Christian is life. To be a Christian is life because God will ask you one day about this. After this, they're going to distribute the crown. But after this distribution of crown, they're going to give the garment for everybody. White garment for everybody. Yes, this is Pastor Emmanuel. This is your garment. This is Prophet D. Larry Beckett. This is your garment. This is your garment. After to distribute garment for everybody, we're going to reach to the wedding of the bride. Hallelujah. We're going to celebrate the marriage of the bride. You are there with your garment, your white garment that is shining, and your crown on your head. And the angel, they are clapping their hands. The angel, they are clapping their hands. Rejoice, rejoice, rejoice. Because your work speak to the throne of the Lord. Because your work testify you. Because your work cry out to the throne of the Lord. You are rejoicing. You are there with your crown. You are there with your white garment shining. Oh, the Lord is cleaning your tears. You was crying for a long time. People was mocking against you. People was speaking rubbish against you. But that day, the Lord of the Lord, the King of the Kings, will welcome you in his hand, will wipe out your tears, and will give you a white garment, will give you a crown, will give you a crown. You're gonna celebrate. You're gonna celebrate. You're gonna celebrate. You're gonna celebrate. He will say, my daughter, you are suffering for a long time. He will say, my son, you are suffering for a long time. You are saying, my son, you was crying for a long time. He could say, my daughter, come here. I saw your heart. I saw your suffering. I saw your problem. I saw you when you was fasting. I saw you when you was praying. I saw you when you was singing. I saw you. I saw you. Come here now. Come here now. There is no more sickness. There is no more problem. There is no more landlord. There is no more, no more, no more. There is life and eternal life. The time is coming. The time is coming. The time is coming. The life after death. The life after death. And the life out of flesh is coming. The waiting of the bride. The waiting of the bride. He's crying because of you. He's crying because of you. My wife, what are you doing? My wife, when he's looking to the church, he says, strengthen you guys. Strengthen you guys. I am coming. Even if the problem are too much, even if the world rebuke you, even if nobody wants you, strengthen guys. Be strong guys. Be strong. I'm on my way. I'm on my way. I'm on my way. I'm coming to comfort you. I'm coming to strengthen you. I'm on my way. I'm on my way. He's gonna say, my daughter. He's gonna say, my son. Church, strengthen you. Church, be strong. Even if today you miss what to eat. Even if today you do not have job. Even today you cannot pay your bill. Even today you have problems. But be strong. I'm coming. I'm coming. I'm coming. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, if you believe, say amen. If you believe, say amen.
Welcome to All Power Ministries, where God is empowering His people to be more than conquerors and overcomers. Do you long for change? All Power has something different for you. Do you long to grow in the things of God? All Power has a teaching ministry that will help you to do just that. Do you need healing and deliverance? All Power is equipped with the anointing of the power of God to make manifest healing and deliverance in your life. All are welcome to come and see. Sunday morning services are at 11 o'clock a.m. sharp. And Wednesday evening, healing and deliverance services begin at 6 o'clock p.m. If you are in need of prayer, you can call our prayer line at 413-234-7526. That's 413-234-7526. All Power Ministries is located at 941 East Columbus Avenue in the city of Springfield. God bless you, and we hope to see you soon. Prophet Larry D. Beckett and the All Power family welcomes you.
Hi, good evening. We thank you for tuning in to the message. We have a very special individual by the name of Pastor Emmanuel give a message concerning the end times. I believe today we've entered into the end times, and this is just the beginning of things that will come to pass. We must be observant and diligent, not only to see, but to understand what's taking place. I believe that if you will continue to tune in and listen to this message, I believe you'll receive much revelation concerning the things that are about to happen in the atmosphere in the days to come. Amen.
That day, there is no sun, there is no moon. That day, there is no sun, there is no moon. The Bible says glory will be like sun, will be like moon. The Bible says glory will shine like never before. The Bible says His glory will shine. That day, there is no day, there is no night. It will be a glorious day. Hallelujah. The day of the Lord. This is the wedding of the bride. Hallelujah, church. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I want you to understand, guys, that if God can reveal you about these days, you can feel like you are going to stay in the church for the rest of your life. You can feel like you will never commit any mistake in your life anymore. You can feel like, oh my God, what I was doing, I waste my time. Because God gonna reveal Himself to you. He's gonna show you the glorious day that is coming. I'm telling you, the flesh is your first enemy ever. I'm telling you, your flesh is your first enemy ever. The world is your second enemy ever. But the Bible said, do not worry, because He win the world. Do not worry, because He win the world. He is coming, the master of masters. He is coming, the king of kings. He is coming, the glorious God. He is coming, the powerful kings. He reigns forever. The Bible says, the Psalm 90, that from everlasting to everlasting, He is God. He's bigger, more than everlasting. He's out of time, because time can never contain Him. He's bigger, more than we can imagine He is. He's powerful God. The Bible call Him the Lion of Judah. The Bible call Him the Ancient of Days. Because He's God. When He says yes, nobody can say no. When He open the door, nobody can close it. When He raise you up, nobody can bring you down. Because He's God. Because He's God. When He say yes, nobody can say no. When he said, I'm going to lift you up, nobody can bring you down. Because he's God. When he said, you are healed, nobody can bring the sickness in you. Because he's God. Today, I'm preaching the living Jesus Christ. Today, I'm preaching the Master of Masters. When he said, I'm going to bless you, nobody can curse you. When he said, today, people will see your glory, nobody can refuse. Because he's God. Because he's God. His day is coming. His day is coming. His day is coming. People can speak against you. People can testify against you. But one day, they will respect you. They will respect you. Because he's God. Because he's God. There is time to cry. There is time to laugh. There is time to be tired. There is time to be strong. Because he's God. Keep your strength in him. Keep trusting in him. He is God. He never fell. The president can fail. The millionaire can fail. But I know someone. I know someone. I know someone. I know someone who never fell. I know someone that death don't have power on him. He's called the Master of Masters. If you believe, say amen. If you believe, say amen. You may see it. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. We are going to see the fourth point. The reign of the beast or the Antichrist. The reign of the beast or the Antichrist. Because the beast is calling the Antichrist again. When Jesus Christ will take care of the church in the rapture of the church, what will happen on earth? We are going to see the origin of the beast or Antichrist. 4:1. 4:1. The origin of the beast or Antichrist. First of all, in this point four, the reign of the beast, we are going to read the Revelation 13, 1 up to 10. And 2 Thessalonians 2, 3 up to 12. The reign of the beast or Antichrist. Revelation 13, 1 up to 10, we are going to see the beast that came out of water. The Bible says it had 7 heads and 10 horns. We are going to see the meaning of each head and the horns. We know the beast. What is the meaning of the beast in the realm of spirit? The beast means a kingdom, a reign. This is the meaning of the beast. So this beast that came out of water have 7 heads and 10 horns. We are going to explain the meaning of each head and the horns. 4:1, that we say the origin of the beast or Antichrist. We are going to see Daniel chapter 7 verse 1 up to 8. The origin of the beast. We are going to break down Daniel chapter 7, 1 up to 8. Here we are going to see 4 beasts that come from the sea that Daniel saw in the dream. The Bible says, and I was in my dream, and I saw 4 beasts come out of water. I was troubled in my dreams because it was so hard for him to understand. But the Bible says the fourth beast that he saw, it was very powerful, strange, and it was like he could not explain it so good because it was so different. We are going to explain this beast. These 4 beasts are 4 kingdoms that rule the world. And we are going to explain it one by one, in the year after year, year after year, year after year. for to the time Antichrist will start his work. What is the time the Antichrist will start his work? When the Antichrist will decide, now I have to start my work. The Bible says in the book of Thessalonians, we know that the Antichrist is there. We know that he's there. But what makes him to not working is because the church is still here. The church is still on earth. And as long as the church is still on earth, the Spirit of the Lord, the Holy Spirit, keep moving. Yeah. And the Antichrist can never raise his head as long as the Holy Spirit is here. The Antichrist can never open his mouth as long as the church is here. Jesus Christ can never accept the Antichrist to mix himself with his bride. Never. Never. That is what the Bible says in the book of Thessalonians, that we know that the work of the evil, the work of the rebellion is here. He's here. They are doing their meeting. They are doing everything. They are here. They are doing their ceremonies. They are doing everything they are doing, but they cannot work. They cannot make it public because the Holy Spirit take control. Yes, yes, yes. They organize themselves in the darkness world. They are making their meeting. They make their plans. And they know very good that the time is close. That is why they keep doing their work hardly. Uh-huh. They keep trying all their best how they can convince a lot of people to go to perish with them. But they cannot work openly because the Holy Spirit is still here. We are proud of that. We are going to see 2 Thessalonians 2, 7 up to 8. For 3. We are going to see the message of peace and the campaign of Antichrist. The message of peace and the campaign of Antichrist. When the Antichrist will raise up, the message of peace that he will start with. Understand, guys, that when the Antichrist will raise up, it will be the time that the church will be taken out. And when the church will be taken out of the rapture of the church, there is a lot of confusion that will pop up on earth. There is a lot of misunderstanding that will pop up on earth. Because try to understand, we are here 10 people, we are here 20 people. And or you are in the market or in the mall, suddenly you can see the one who was selling you is not there. Suddenly you figure out that someone who was close to you disappeared. Or you are in the bus, suddenly you figure out the driver is disappeared. Amen. Some people will run mad. Other people will never understand it. We are in the church, suddenly you see the pastor is no longer there. You start to look right and left. We are praying, we are closing eyes, suddenly you open your eyes, you find you are 2 people in the church. Other people left. Amen. We're going to be, for example, in the bus stop, you are waiting for the bus. Suddenly, 20 people disappear. You are going to look around. I heard someone close to me. What is going? Yeah. You have your baby. You are going in the to the appointment. Suddenly, you figure out your baby is no longer there. There will be confusion on earth. The news will keep crying. The news will start talking, oh, there is something that happened, this happened, this happened, this happened, but they don't know that we know the secret. We know the secret. So for those times that will pop up there, there will be, those confusion will be, those confusion, misunderstanding, something like that, and will make the time for the Antichrist to start his work. Listen, how he gonna start? He will take advantage for those problems and start preaching. No, these people, they are going for their judgment. Do not worry about them. I am someone who will bring peace. Listen to me. He's going to start preaching. Cool down, guys. Cool down. Why are you crying for the people who are going to pay according to their evil? He will try to convince people that those who went are bad. You who stay, you are good. He will try to start preaching to make people to understand. Don't worry. I will make you guys to be better. I will make the world to be a better place. I will do all my best for you to be happy. I will try all my best for you to have money. He will start preaching. And people will listen to him because the Bible says he will convince the people with signs and wonders. That is the Bible says. He will convince people with sign and wonders. He will start doing sign. He will start doing wonders. The Bible says even call fire from heaven, he will do it. And people will be convinced, really? This is so strange. We have to believe in this one. That is the Bible says, the book of Thessalonians, when you hear peace, understand that bad things will come in suddenly. He will start to preach. He will start to make people to understand. Don't worry about these people who left. Don't worry about them. Focus your mind on me. Focus your strength in me. I will help you. I will change the world. I will make the world a better place. Because he will pop up in the time that the Christ will be so much on the world. He will appear in the time that the hunger will be so much in the world. He will appear in the time that the crazy economic will be so much in the world. He will appear in the time that many problems will be so much in the world. And it is something that they are prepared for themselves. Because they know that we prepare this for someone to come to bring solution to these problems. And when he will start to preach, he will do some sign and wonders, and people will trust in him. He will give money to the bank. He will give money to a lot of people. He will make people to understand that I will make the world to have one common money, one bank, one. He will make people to understand that all the world will be one. And he will do it. He will break down all the borders. All the world will be one. But after that, what will happen? When he will start to do those signs and wonders, when he will start to convince people the mistakes that he shall do, he's going to go in the temple of Israel. Step in and tell to Israel that I am God. To worship me. That is the point when the problem will start. Israel will look at him and say, yes, you was doing sign. You was doing wonders. But what you are saying now, we know there is only one God in heaven. We know that there is only one God in heaven. So what you are saying is so strange, and he will be mad. So when he's going to be mad, he will, all the country, he's going to renew all the country together. And they're going to start the fight against Israel that we call Armageddon. Five points, the war of Armageddon. Revelation 16, 13 up 16. Zechariah 14, 1. Up to the war of Armageddon. This is what the Bible says, Armageddon. The Bible says they will kill Israel. They will kill Israel about to finish all the rest of Israel. Because all the country of the world will raise against him. But what will happen next? Jesus Christ will come and rescue Israel. We are going to see it here. Zechariah 14. That's the sixth point, the second coming of Jesus Christ.
chapter 6, the second coming of Jesus Christ. Zechariah 14, 3 up to 7. We are not yet starting our lesson. We are giving only the point. Zechariah 14, 3 up to 7. We are going to see how Jesus Christ will come and when his feet will step on the mountain of Olivet in Israel, the mountain will be split twice. When only his feet will step on the mountain will not resist to the glory of the King of Kings. The mountain will never resist to the glory of the powerful God. The mountain will be split twice. The Bible says, and Israel will take a look and they will run in the mountains. And when the nations will come after Israel to fight them and to finish them, the Bible says, he will destroy them with the breath out of his mouth. Hallelujah. Zechariah 14, 3 up to 7. Revelation 22, 12 up to 13. Six, one, the judgment of Israel. Matthew 19, 28. 6:2, the judgment of nation. Matthew 25, 31 up to 46. We are going to see when Jesus Christ will come for the second time. Here on the mountain of Olivet, the Bible says that after to rescue Israel from the Antichrist, he's going to make what we call the judgment of Israel first. You refuse me, you guys. You remember when I was going to Golgotha. You cry out and say that may my blood be upon you and upon your grandchildren. Okay, so I want to judge you now. Why did you say that? Amen. It will be the judgment of Israel. And they will start to confess and say, forgive us, Lord. We didn't know that it was you. We was waiting you to come as a king. But you came as a slave. Because that's what the Bible says. The Israel, they are waiting for Jesus Christ to come as a king. And when he came as a slave, they didn't recognize him. Because the prophet was prophesied that he will come to rescue them. So when the prophet was prophesied like that, and Israel took it serious and said that Jesus Christ will come as a king. And when he came as a slave, they rebuked him. So he will start to judge them and they will confess. The Bible says that you don't know, guys, that you're going to judge the 12 tribe of Israel. That time, you're going to judge them. After the judgment of Israel, it will become the judgment of nation. We know that in this time, when the church will be taken out, there is some nation that will still here on earth. The people that knew that this time that we are living, the church is no longer on earth. It will be a time that the Bible says, those who want to see the face of the Lord, they will save their soul through their blood. When they will start to distribute the mark of the beast, the Bible says they will refuse the mark of the beast till death. And because the grace will no longer there, the spirit of the Lord will no longer there, they will save their soul through their own blood. They will kill them so that they can receive salvation. This is a time that you can receive salvation through the grace of God. This is a time that you can be saved through the power of the Holy Spirit. They don't need you to shed your blood. They don't need you to do a lot of effort. But the time is coming that the grace will no longer there. The time is coming that the grace will no longer there. You shall look for the grace and you will never find it.
You shall look for a preacher and you will never find him. You shall look for a church and will never find him. The Bible says people will cry for the mountain to fall upon them. People will cry for the mountain to kill them. And the mountain will say, no, my time is over. The Bible, people will look for death. Death, where are you? I need to die. The Bible says God will contain death and hide it. Nobody will die till you shed your own blood through your power. Hallelujah. People will try all their best. You can take a knife to kill yourself, but you will not die. The time is coming. When they advise you go to church, you look right, you look left, you pass, you are going like you are Miss World. Hallelujah. When they are telling you that you need to go to the service, you say, I'm busy. Right. You are busy. The time is coming, you will be really busy. Hallelujah. The time is coming, you will be really, really busy. Busy crying. The time that the Bible said the grass will no longer there. People will try all their best to look, where is the church? Where can I go even to sit down for the pastor to pray for me? Where can I go even to sit 2 minutes to receive Jesus Christ? No one will be there. You will do all your best. And they will come, they will ask you a couple questions. Okay? Do you know the one that they was preaching? The one who is in heaven, because they cannot say the name of Jesus Christ. If you say no, okay, they give you the mark of the beast, they give you everything that you want. But if you say no, I believe in him, they will start to cut the part one piece by piece. They start by the finger, they go little by little, little by little, little by little. You feel like you can run mad for you to save your own soul through your blood. People will suffer. You still have time now to give your life to Jesus Christ. You still have time now to give yourself to God. You still have time now to do the work of God with all your heart. You still have time now to contribute to the work of God. You have time to decide. Because the world will never help you to nothing. Because out there, the Bible said there is only dogs, there is only evil things. They will never help you to nothing. You still have time to concentrate your mind to the work of God. You still have time because Jesus Christ needs you. You still have time. The time is coming that you will miss even the time to listen to the gospel. The time is coming that you shall look for the men of God and you shall miss them. The time is coming that you shall cry, where can I receive even or to hear the gospel? You're going to miss it. The Bible says, when I'm saying, do not turn out your heart against me. Listen to the Lord. He needs you. We are facing a very serious time that the Lord needs to save the church. The Lord needs to save his people. But the time that we are now is the time that people, they don't want, they don't care about the work of God. The people don't care about the gospel. The people, they don't care about Jesus. But I want you to understand that it's time for you to make a decision. It's time for you to make a decision. Because the time is coming that you will no longer have that time no more. When they are asking you, they are telling you that you need to pray. You need to come to church on time. You need to respect the man of God. You need to respect the ruler of the work of God. You have the response that nobody can resist. When you are talking, nobody can resist on your words. Your words are like fire. Your words are like knife. When they are telling you about the church,
you can give a response, maybe that can make the world to fall down. But I want you to understand that the Lord will judge you according to what you did on earth. The Bible says the words that we spoke through your mouth shall be judged by the Lord. Every word that you spoke, notice it on the throne of the Lord. This is a time you need to make a decision. This is a time you need to concentrate yourself. Because I want you to understand, if I give this lesson, it's because you to know that the time that you are facing is the last days. We are living all the signs of the last days. The last sign that we was waiting for was the capital city of Jerusalem. That was the last sign. The capital city of Jerusalem to be recognized as the capital city of Jerusalem, because it was for Palestine. And the Palestinian was fighting for Jerusalem. The Israel too was fighting for Jerusalem. But when God allowed Donald Trump to raise, he used him for the Jerusalem to go back to Israel. That is in the Bible. It is the last prophecy. One thing that remains is when they're going to start to build the temple of Solomon. Very soon, it's going to start. And they're going to build the temple because the Antichrist, he's going to step in the temple. And the war is going to start there. I want you to understand that you do not have time to waste. Don't have time to waste. The devil is trying to raise a lot of things. The technology will pop up like never before. Things will come up like crazy. Every day, new things. Every day, this come out. Every day, this come out. Every day, this come out. It's not because we are living in the good world, because they want you to perish. Yeah. They want you to focus your mind on things that come out and to give back to the gospel. When you said then you hear the news, they are saying, oh, this come out again. This come out again. We have iPhone 12. We have, I don't know this. We have this Mercedes-Benz like this. We have this kind of, we have this and this. You keep your eyes on that and the gospel keep going. Yeah. Yeah. The gospel keep yeah. going. Yeah. And the darkness keep coming. Mm-hmm. And the light keep finishing. Uh-huh. Yes. Uh-huh. You are busy here. And Jesus Christ is coming here. The Bible said those who have the ears to hear, they're going to hear what the Spirit is telling to listen. On the judgment of the nation, the Lord Jesus Christ is going to separate the goat and the sheep. The Bible says he's going to put the goat on his left and the sheep on his right. In this time, those who allow, accept to shed their blood because of the gospel, they will be among the sheep. In this time, those who didn't allow to shed their blood because of Jesus Christ, they will be among the goats. After this, we are going to enter in the period that is calling millennium. The millennium is a period that Jesus Christ will reign for 1,000 years. In this period, the Bible says the devil will be locked for 1,000 years. We are going to open this later. But I want you to understand that we do not have time to waste. We do not have time to waste. You can see how people celebrate sin like never before. You can see how people celebrate evil like never before. This don't remind you nothing? You can see how the world celebrate evil. You can see, you have the eyes to see, guys. The Lord creates men and the woman to get married, but here you can see a man and man is married. Let us be honest, guys. Is really God say the man and man can be married? We cannot speak it out again because you know that the country, the government will raise against you. You. Really? The government will say you don't have love. Let love. Okay.
Love is not bad, but let it make it in the right way. Let it make it in the right way, please. Oh, you hate people. This is not hatred. This is truth. You can see how the government proclaim evil. They keep voting the law for abortion. Really? Really? Where did you saw this? Is it really this in the Bible? The Bible says because of the greatness of evil, the love of people will grow cold. Where did you saw this? A parent can no longer have a word to his child again. No more. You cannot advise your children again. No. That day, you will know where is the police. I didn't know this when I came here. Oh, they will call 911 on you. Really? I said, okay. I didn't know that. I said, oh, really? I cannot advise my daughter again. I cannot advise my son again. This is not good. How come you can come with your boyfriend in my house? You come with your girlfriend in my house and I'm there. Welcome. This is your bedroom. Really? I advise sin to sin. So, if you are a parent, God give you the children for you to allow sin to them, he will ask you. The Bible says children are the blessing from the Lord. If the children are the blessing from the Lord, raise them in the way of the Lord. You can see how evil can keep pop up. You can see how sins keep being celebrating. But when you're speaking about the truth, they can't hear you. If I step out here to start to preach about the gospel, they're going to tell me that you are making noise. But if someone pass here with his car and the music everywhere, they will say, enjoy your life. Amen. You can see how the devil twists things. But we need to understand that these are the signs of the last days. The King of Kings is coming. The King of Kings is in his way. Yeah. Be strong, guys. Yeah. Because even if you can see sins keep pop up like this, understand that our master is on his way. Our master is on his way. Oh, our master is on his way. They keep celebrating evil here. We know that we welcome our master here. They keep celebrate evil here. We know that the guy is the Lord of the Lord. He's coming. That is why he said, be strong, church. Even if you can see all those kind of things, don't mix yourself with them, because I'm coming. I'm coming. I'm coming. I know that people hate you because you speak the truth. I know that people hate you because you don't mix yourself with them. But keep doing that. Be strong, because I'm coming. I'm coming. I'm coming. It's so hard for you, but be strong. I'm coming. I'm coming. The time is too short. I'm coming. Be strong. Don't give up, please. Don't give up. Don't mix yourself up. Don't mix yourself. I'm coming. Be strong, church. May God bless his word. Amen.
Morning services are at 11 o'clock a.m. sharp, and Wednesday evening healing and deliverance service begin at 6 o'clock p.m. If you are in need of prayer, you can call our prayer line at 413-234-7526. That's 413-234-7526. All Power Ministries is located at 941 East Columbus Avenue in the city of Springfield. God bless you, and we hope to see you soon. Prophet Larry D. Beckett and the All Power family welcomes you.